Well, hello everyone, and welcome to Banished. No, I haven't abandoned my colonial charter and Megamod let's play. I just kind of thought I have never actually tried a game with only colonial charter installed, not the earlier versions either. I've always had colonial charter plus some other mods installed, and I was kind of wondering what is actually part of that mod if you just play it by itself. So I thought I would try that, and then, well, I might as well record it at the same time. And if you like to watch it, then let me know and I'll make some more episodes. But for now, let's get started. As you can see, I only have the Colonial Charter 1.71 journey installed and enabled. Well, I have the other ones installed too, but it's the only one that's enabled for this. So let's see, we're gonna go with a new one. We're just gonna kind of randomize this a little bit. And I was thinking I want to try a new map. Usually when I play this, well, in the Vanilla version, I would usually just choose valleys and maybe mountains, but I kind of like the flatter ground, though the mountains can offer a different challenge. I might actually do one of these for a modded one, where we have some more mountains. I don't know if any of these maps have a lot of mountains. It doesn't really. Well, there's the Bleak Mountain map. So maybe one of those. Eventually I would actually like to try them all. Oh, my mouse is acting up a little bit. Okay. And then when I play modded, I usually choose lake waters. I kind of like that. Then you get the lakes to play around with. And I was considering doing a water world. Or picking the water world terrain. But then I thought no, because, well, just let us go through these with. I'm picking a very large map, I always do that. I like to have some room to play around with. And the climate, we'll get back to that. We're leaving disasters on. And what I wanted to try, there are all these options, of course. Well, the silk road is where you can make silk right from the beginning. And the new frontier, where you start off with the, I think it's a small fort or something. It's just different ways to start out. There's also one where you have kind of a, yeah, the shipwreck, or that's your storage, that's a boat. There's the all the wild things, where it's kind of unrealistic, I think they say, because you have an abundance of natural food resources. So there are all these options, and then there are a lot of these where it's just different types of trees. But I thought I would really like, let's see, the Curse of the Golden Llama. I've never tried this. I know it's something about you can add an adventurer that brings back some artifacts or something, but I thought I would like to try this one. And of course I start with hard. I usually always do that. I could do an Adam and Eve, but that's what I did in the other Let's Play. So I think we're gonna go with hard this time. Let's see how it goes. It says, the Curse of the Golden Llama is the closest thing to a mystery in the world of Banished. What is the Golden Llama? What mysteries does it hold? Dare you explore its murky interior. This is a game that starts according to regular hard settings, but includes the option to adventure for the chance at treasure. See, that sounds really interesting, so I thought we're gonna try this. And since we are going with something like that, I thought, well, that would make sense that we had kind of tropical map, maybe? And I don't know, it just made me think of something like well, it could be Asia, but no, it made me think of the Amazon or South America, actually. So, I thought maybe we'll go with the jungle rivers. I've never tried this map either. And very large, and since we have the jungle rivers, of course we're gonna try the tropical map. So, we'll see how it goes. I've actually don't really know how the temperature affects what you can grow in crop fields and orchards and such, so we'll just try an experiment. I don't know if it's realistic, so you have to kind of watch what you plant, that some things won't grow. And the same if you choose, for instance, the harsh arid, very hot and cold, or the very harsh map. I'm actually not sure, maybe it says something. Yeah, it says something down here. Note, some crops and orchards will only grow if they are within suitable temperature ranges. This depends on your choice of climate. However, most crops and orchards will grow in most settings. Growth is usually only affected by extreme climates. Okay. So, tropical? Well, we'll see. We'll just test things out. And what are we gonna call this? Just something simple. Lamerton Rivers. Settle. Oh, you can't go any further than that. Okay, well, Lamerton Rivers. That's just gonna be it. So, let's go. And we'll see if it, how this will go, how it will turn out. I've actually also been considering starting a vanilla game, because I still have one achievement that I haven't done. Not that the achievements really matter, but it's kind of fun to go for them sometimes. But the one I'm missing is the one where you have to reach, I think it's 500 citizens by year 200. So it takes a really long time. And that's the reason I don't have it, because I kind of got bored. Because the last time I was doing achievements, I did over half of them in just one game. I think about when I got to that point, I was just kind of bored. So I never really did the last one. I think it's called Tenure or something like that. So I was considering starting one of those games, and I may do that kind of by myself. Maybe I'll record the beginning of it, and if anyone seems interested, I might post some updates, but we'll see. It might also get too much for me to be playing three different games at the same time, but I don't know. Okay, this is taking... Oh, there we go. We're gonna pause. Oh, it's really taking some time this time. Okay, so it looks like the grass has a different texture on this jungle map. That's interesting. So, oh, and there's a small sign there with an exclamation sign. So let's see. Quest, Curse of the Golden Llama. Welcome to Colonial Shadows Curse of the Golden Llama quest. This sign can be demolished but cannot be rebuilt. Hundreds of years have gone by since the ancient civilization living here was wiped out by a combination of old world diseases, war, and famine. Greedy explorers flocking here en masse disappeared one by one into the dense woods without a trace, never to be heard from again. Interesting. Those that did come back lived out their lives, were very rich men indeed. Now you're here for a totally different reason to survive. Will you succumb to the same fate as those brave, perhaps stupid, dead men and women, or will you pay the ancient gods in blood for your wealth? Okay, I'm not sure. And then it just says something here with some strange letters. Okay. And we have 100 firewood, 20 hide coats, 20 iron tools, 1200 potatoes. And let's see, we should maybe get some stuff up here. Our general statistics and our event luck. And map. Just gonna pop that up here. Can you only have a small map in this? It might be a... is it just me? Maybe that's part of the mega map then, that you can have like a bigger map. Anyway, well, it doesn't actually look like there's a lot of water on this map. Well, there is, but it's kind of tiny rivers, so... wonder how that works. Let's see, but we do have the big river right next to us, so that's kind of nice. And the profession list. Just gonna pop that over there. So that is all we usually have, I think. Oh, and we have this one, the native monument. Okay, so we can put someone to work there, but I think right for this, right now I'm just gonna leave it. It's until we kind of get started. Just gonna check our limits. Just gonna bump these up a little bit. It's found, hurts. Good. Don't really want a limit on that. That's fine. There we go, let's see. So we have 12 citizens, 8 adults, 4 children, and 1200 food, yeah, some firewood and all that. And it's only 21 degrees, that's a kind of very temperate actually. So that's not bad. Let's take a look at our surroundings. So, have our river going down here. And one kind of breaking off. Oh, and that's a nice mountain. Does look different from... it actually looks like stone mountain, where the one in... vanilla map or the other map we're playing, it looks more like it's sand or something and a little grass. This looks like actual stone. So, oh, can we zoom in? Oh, just felt like we could zoom in more than usual. Usually. Okay. Well, we do have a nice mountain right there where we might do some mining. Oh, and oh, we are right here on the tip. That's pretty neat, actually. And that goes out here. Okay. Let's see. Let's see. What are we gonna do? Okay. Just taking a look. Might make sense to get some foresting. Foresters and gatherers and hunters and such going here. And maybe some fishing might be nice over here somewhere. Or right there maybe. That would be a really nice spot too. Or around, oh, that would be a perfect spot for fishing, I think. Okay. Oh, what is that? Oh, it was just the graphics. Just for a second it looked like there was fish there. Okay. Let's see. Now I'm just... well, we do have some options to play with. Actually, we have a lot. I'm a little surprised there's this much. But not as many storage options as we are used to from the other game. Oh, and very few here compared to the other one. Okay, well, this is gonna be interesting. There are some things to play around with. This one. Oh, we can even build a stable here for domesticated animals and wild shepherds, shows. Several mining options. Okay. And not quite as many different luxurious production buildings. Not sure which one, but I think something is missing here too. I think there were one or two tabs more in the other in when you used the Mega Mod too. But we do have the quay buildings available. Modular and all these old buildings. Oh, that's cool. I like that we have these. Okay. And some decorations, but oh, there are some ghost decorations. Okay. Well, I was just checking because I've literally no idea what we have here. Okay, there's not that many houses actually. We have row houses and colonial houses. That's these ones. And the New England colonial set. Okay. Oh, we have the Georgian houses. These are really nice. And we have three different boarding houses, a large gable country house. Okay. Well, let's get started anyway. I'm just kind of checking things out. What do we need? What do we need? We need some houses, we need some resources, we need a stockpile. Should we just bump that in right here? I just want to see where I actually want to build something, but I'm thinking this actually might be perfect place for our town, main town, and we can have some fishing going around and have some trading, and we're gonna expand across the river. But that this might actually kind of be the main town. Maybe we could kind of go for just one big town. In the other Let's Play, I've been kind of trying to cover the map with lots of small towns and farmsteads and such, and maybe we should just kind of start in the middle and branch out and see if we can kind of build one big town. It'd be an idea actually. So let's see, I'm just gonna plan some stuff out here if we're gonna do that. Because then I would kind of like to have, we're not gonna build this right now, but I just wanna kind of place a market down so we have that as in the center, kind of in the center. Do we want this one? I'll let you guys see what it looks like. It's not for sure that you've all watched the other episode or even know this much, so. Then we have the Old Town Market, which I really like too. I think I would prefer to place that somewhere where we have some fields, maybe. That would look really cool. Then we have the Rural Market. And the Edibles Market. Okay. That's not a very interesting building, actually. It looks more like a storage barn, just... You have this small market. Oh, can change the roof and the wall tiles. Oh, walls anyway. And then we have all these small stalls, which could be pretty cool actually. Okay, so we don't have that many options. Well, we have lots of options like this, but we don't have a lot of these markets. We have these small carts. Well, it might also be fun to kind of use these and just kind of spread them out instead of having like one market. Oh no, probably not as efficient. But I'm just thinking that might be fun to do that. Kind of drop them in between. I think we're gonna do something like that. Okay, I'm just trying to figure out what I actually want to do with this. Yeah, we need some resources, like I said. Maybe we'll just pop them over here for now and get these people started collecting some resources, which means we actually just want to clear most of this. We do want some foresters and such. And I think I want to implement those as kind of part of the city, maybe. So we want some wood, most of all. There we go. And then I'm just gonna let them get stone. And just let you guys get a little bit of iron. And maybe just let them run a little bit. And what do we want? We really need to get a house down. Could do the tiny shack, or maybe make some wooden houses. Do the rustic abodes. That might be cool to use these. What else do we have? Stone houses. Country houses, we don't have resources for that yet, so we kind of have to stick in this end. Well, I feel like stone house might be kind of strange for this jungle theme. Maybe wooden houses would be best. And we kind of have this llama that I kind of... But do we want that sign? Because I just think that's kind of annoying, and I don't think it has any function, it's just there. Of course we could kind of do like this, or just leave it. No, like this. Yeah, we're just gonna leave it for now. So what are we gonna do with all these houses? I'm gonna put a couple of houses. I'm not gonna build them all right now, just kind of placing some stuff down here. This wooden house, and of course we need a couple of builders. There we go. Just gonna get you guys to prioritize this. I know we don't have, there's probably not enough room for all these people, but it's not, as far as I remember, you can actually make do with one house as long as they have somewhere they can go and get warm. But the first winter. But we also really want to get some wood cutting going. So what do we have here? We have this chopper and a normal woodcutter. Smithing, dumper construction. And then there's saw kits and stuff, but for right now. I think right here we're just gonna go with this one. Maybe we could place kind of. Give him a place to work right behind this. I think I prefer the soil road actually. That. Maybe bring the road like that. Okay, so we have our first house down and it's still only spring, so that's nice. And now we have the chopper going. There we go. Probably gonna need some more stone. Just gonna put a few stone there. There we go. Then we really need to get some food going, so should we start with some fishing maybe? Right there. Or we could do a hunting pond. Telephone. We need weeds for that. Color set. Okay, we can make an apiary here. So we only have one fisher. One type here. But I think this could be a really nice spot for fishermen. Right there, so the boat kind of. Okay. No, right there. There we go. There we go with that, and we got another house in. And we're gonna need a road going to this thing. And what do we have? Okay, we have. Like this. Oh, you're still working on that. Okay, well, I would kind of like you to come and check out this fisherman. Oh, and we already have some more adults. That was fast. But yeah, I have to get used to that too, because I've been using the 1 year is 1 year mod in my other Let's Play, so children are gonna grow up much faster in this one. Then we are gonna need some storage for these fish. So let's see what we have. Gotta check here. Oh, we have the normal storage barn. Actually kind of be nice to have one of these in town here. It's gonna be a cap, I think. Right about there. And that. Just gonna pause it for now. And then we need something for us. Fisherman. Could do something like that. A small barn. We have this old barn. Interesting. Oh, these are too good. Egg drying. Oh, there's the meat locker. stores meat and meat products, including nuts and fish. Yeah, we could go with a cellar and this lean-to storage options. They will have two variants to choose from, and then they look a little bit different. They have a small sign that shows what's supposed to be put in them. See. Oh, we want the meat luck, maybe. What fit right next to fisherman? Like that. And then, of course, we're gonna need some houses out here. Shed, rustic boat. Well, we could also do something with the. Let's see. We could do some duck stuff. I kind of forgot about that. So, of course, we have a fisherman there too. So, I think we're gonna do that elsewhere. We also have the quay buildings, actually. That's a fisherman also. But we need lumber for that. I really like these small houses you can kind of put on the edge here. And then there are walls that you can put below. So you can build some really nice stuff. I haven't played around with this much. But I might do that in this let's play because we have all this water right around us. So might do something up with that. Temple, stone house. There we go. A rustic abode. But I also just wanted to take something because we might actually. I was just thinking we're gonna need a bridge somewhere. But I think that's probably gonna be over there. Unless we can do something through the mountain, but I'm not sure we can get a foothold. Well, we might be able to. I think it would be kind of cool to make a tunnel and then continue right on to a bridge. And yeah, again, I'm not really going for efficiency, so I might put some houses instead of putting everything right on top of each other like this, which is most efficient. The most efficient would be to put the two houses here. But I kind of want to make it a bit different than that. Because I was thinking maybe we could put a hunting blind out here too. So I think we're just gonna leave a little gap. And then we can't because that's where the road is, so we're gonna put them a little offset, but that's fine. Doesn't bother me at all. Okay, and it's summer, so it would be a good idea. Our food is at 67? Yeah. How many people do we have? I think we're just gonna pop in 3 people here. Get some fish going. And our meat locker is almost done, so that's perfect. Then we need choppers to make some firewood. And yeah, we can only have one person here, but that's fine for now. There we go. And I was talking about hunting blind. Well, we need reeds for that, of course. But I would probably like to put it out here anyway. And see if we can find a place for it to fit. No, doesn't look like it. Oh, we could put it right down the edge. Might be fine. And we still need some reeds, but we'll get those eventually. I'll go with the solid road again for now. So right there. And it's the road going here. And like that. Shouldn't it like leave room? There we go. So we should have room for another house here, maybe. Right there. There we go. Just gonna pause that for now. And the meat log is done. Oh yeah. So let's see, we should hopefully have some food coming in soon. And we should have some firewood. Yeah, we are getting some firewood. Still need some more houses, but they are getting built. And how are we on resources? We have 16 stone and we need... there we go, just need 6. That's fine. Just gonna collect a little bit more. Here and there. Go. And the rustic abode, which you can see it can be upgraded. Right housing. For residents, that's the town about this one you can actually build. It is right there. You can build it straight away, but you need lumber for that, and we don't have that yet. Two versions. And then we can upgrade it to a townhouse where we can have 6 residents. But we need housewares, something for that. So let's see, we have 1, 2, 3 houses down, and we still have 5 people without a home. What do you say about these? We can only have 4 people. So we're probably gonna need to build the last one too. I might just do that and just see when they finish this. And we got some fish coming in. That's good. I'm pretty low on food at the moment, so I think maybe we'll just pop in another fisherman to kind of build up some a stock of food so we can make it through the winter. And the reason our firewood and well food too is going down so fast is because they are all gonna fill their houses and with firewood and food. And for anyone who's new to the game, you need 1 person eats 100 food per year. So you can see we have 14, so we actually need 1400 food for 1 year. It's good to have in stock at least that much. Because then you have for at least 1 year if something happens. Preferably I like to have more than that, but and this doesn't show you how much you have in the houses. It only shows you what you have in storage, so it goes down fast, but they have like 194 potatoes, these have 192 potatoes. So they will... I've never really noticed, but I think they try to store enough for 2 people or something, maybe even more than that. Let's see, what do you have? 67, yeah, but then you got some fish. And of course they're storing some firewood too. See, it's empty, but they'll fill it up really soon. Okay, let's see, we have 3 people left. We have 1 child there. No children. 1 child, that's 2. 3. Okay, so it should be 1 child and 2 parents. So 1 more house, that should be enough. When this one gets built. And they can then have a child, and these can have more children, because they can, I think it's 5 people that can live in the wooden houses, if I remember correctly. There we go. Okay, so we've got our houses down. Almost. Well, we still have this one, but they can go and heat up if it gets too cold. So it shouldn't be a big problem. Might just tell them to prioritize. There's this really nice button here. It only works for laborers as far as I know, so it will just speed up that they bring the resources here, like the stone and logs we're missing, but it won't force the builders to come here and build. But they don't really have anything else to do at the moment. So when the builders don't have anything to build, they'll just act as laborers. And actually the same thing goes for any other building. If they're out of resources or they hit the cap, like for tools, our cap is 50. So once they reach 50, then the blacksmith, which we haven't built yet, will go and act as a laborer for a little while until it drops below 50, then he will go back to work. So I think, well, 1 fisherman should be good for now. Yeah, we've got 400 fish so far in this season, but it hasn't been here for very long. So I think I'm gonna add some more food production, but I think we're gonna see if we can get a blacksmith down, because we really want to make sure we have enough tools and clothes, especially tools, because if we run out of tools, then it will slow down production a lot. So that is really important. So let's see, that should be under refined resources. I'm pretty sure I'm probably forgetting something really important I ought to be building, but we'll see how it goes. This is the normal blacksmith. And then we have the city blacksmith for advanced production. And all kinds of other stuff. Yeah. So what do we need for this one? Wood, stone and iron. 32 iron. And yeah, it's a little confusing. It says wood. Oh, it doesn't. It's the icon for wood. And for stone and for iron. But this iron is iron bars and not iron ores, which often confuses people. So we actually do have 23 iron ore stored. But this won't go up until we implement a melter and start turning it into iron bars. So I think we're just gonna tell them to get a little more iron, since we'll need this for the blacksmith. And probably some more stone. There we go. So let's see where we're gonna build the blacksmith. Okay. So we have a storage barn right there with a it'd be nice to put it right there. And yeah, I know then I can't fit at least not a wooden house there, but I think maybe we'll put one of those small market buildings or something. We're gonna put it right there. And the last house is done, and yeah, they all went in there, so that's good. So, let's see how it's looking. I have 192 food, so it's... And those are probably gonna pop into that one house, but I think they all have enough food to survive for the season anyway. And we have more fish coming in. Yeah, almost 600 fish, so that's nice. Reserve of firewood low, yeah, but it's going up. We're at 73 now, we're way further down before. So where are you storing that? You're storing it right there. Might be a good idea with a stockpile for this guy, because I don't intend on keeping this one. It's just a temporary one. So it might be a very nice right here behind the barn. And for now, it would be really nice if you guys would focus on the blacksmith. And yeah, I know the coats are also going down, so we also have to get a tailor done very soon. But I always feel like the tools are very much more important. Much more important. So, let's see, maybe we should do... Maybe... Fuel. And fuel, and then maybe do a wooden one. Yeah. Well, let me roll. Just go like this. And... Yeah, we want this one. To be wood and it wasn't what I wanted to do. That pew. There we go. And then bring the road around a little bit. Yeah, I know I'm telling you guys some stuff that most of you probably know, at least of the viewers that I've talked to recently. They probably know even more about the game than I do. But if anyone is new to the game and considering trying it out, I just thought I would add some extra information. It's not an actual tutorial, but you know, just a little bit of info, so you know what's going on. But if you have any more questions, just post them in the comments, and I'll be sure to read them and answer them as good as I can. How it's going. YouTube. Reserve of logs is low. Oh, we still don't have 94 logs. Just trying to get that blacksmith built. And maybe we should look into where we want the tailor. It's probably here. Tailor and company, which we can't build, so. Well, yeah. So where do we want you? Well, we could put you kind of in the back here somewhere, maybe next to the blacksmith. No, we want to mix it up a little bit, but maybe here. That's close to the barn. Just put a little bit of room. Cool. And bring the road around this, I think. And we still need some more stone. Okay. I better let you get those. And we had 3, 4 new children. Okay. 124. Well, our firewood is going up really nicely, so that's good. Like this, make the road a little offset, and there were those. Let's see, see if I can remember where things are. Okay, fruit stone, vegetable stone, there's no fruit, protein, clothing, and tools. Can you fit right there? Well, you can actually. Maybe one over. Well, I'm trying to kind of. The reason I'm making these small gaps is because I would like to leave some room so you can pop in some trees and some flowers or some other decorations. Or maybe kind of over here in between the sailor and the. No, I think maybe this is better if we want to reach more houses, because otherwise we cover a lot of water. So this might be a good idea. Yeah. Something like... Ooh, right there. There we go. Just gonna pause that too. Okay, so... maybe it would be a good idea to check, look into some more food. Let's see, how is it going? We have 4 laborers and 2 builders, so one of them is going to be a blacksmith. And the other one, a tailor, but I'm thinking we can kind of switch between them, so like that the blacksmith work for a little and then change him over to a tailor so that we have more people to build and work as laborers. So where would we like some more food production? Let's see. Do would like a forester? And since this is a jungle, maybe we should pick one of those. And there's the new trees. I don't know if this is the new trees that we have here. We do have a lot of palm trees. Used to exclusively plant palm and tropical trees. That should be the one. We can do bamboo wood trees too. And of course there are a lot of you can make kind of a fruit tree forester. As far as I know, you still only get the logs from them, but it just looks differently. Okay, yeah, I think we're gonna go with this one. Just want to see how big it is. Oh, wow. Okay. So not over there. I think we might want to do some mining along this ridge, so I don't want to go too close to that. And it is kind of a hill or something there, so maybe just... right at the edge of the market circle, maybe. Go! Oh, and the blacksmith is done, that's perfect. And we're just gonna make some rough tools for now. And this one can be upgraded too. You can upgrade it to a country smithy or a large smithy to be able to make more advanced tools. But we need some resources that we don't have yet. That looks like building supplies. And I think the tool limit of 50 is fine for now. We don't have that many people. Did I? Yeah, well, that's getting close to being done too. So since we're gonna have a forester here, it would be nice to clear out all the iron and stone from this area, so we can have a lot of trees growing here. More or less like this. Wow, then they have a lot to do. That's fine. So we want a road going out here. So how are we gonna do that? That place, and maybe we should do something like this. Maybe to right there. And right there, and bring the road down to about here, and there. Yeah. What are we? Oh, tools. Yeah, but that's going up. We already have 10 tools, so we have almost we'll soon have enough for everyone. And our food is going up. Our firewood is going up. So we just need to get the tailor working before we run out of clothes. Which means we need a hunter. We really need to get a hunter going. Well, for leather. Otherwise we can make survival coats, but for that we need feathers and reeds, I think. Which means we will need to get the hunting blind going, but I think we can get... Well, I'm not sure, but I do think we get some reeds from the gatherer, maybe. Can't remember. I can't remember, but it's okay. For now, we just want... no more hunting cabin, I think. We have two options. But I think this is pretty cool. And you can see the heights. Oh, and it has a really big circle too. And I'm not actually completely sure if it has to. I usually always place it here in the forest area, but I don't think it actually has to be in the forest area. It's supposed to be somewhere where there are some deer you can hunt, or some ducks like this. I have some ducks flying around over here and there. Where do we have? I saw some deer earlier. Probably hiding in the trees. Yeah, have some right down here. Right there. I don't know if you can guys can see them. Oh, there we go. Like, right there. So, this might be a good place for the hunting cabin. Let's see if we can find some more. Well, they do move around, so... Might have some other ones passing through. There we go, where did we put the right there? And the deer is right there. Okay. But I am thinking maybe we should just pop it in. Maybe further up this way. See if I can spot some animals. Yeah, we have some there. Oh, looks like there's even a baby one. What? I didn't know that. Oh yeah. It just looks a little strange that it has horns, like the big ones. I don't think they have that early anyway. It usually it's something you can tell the age based on how many kind of, what do you call those branches sticking off the horns. Yeah, just with the tailor. Let's see, we can make head coat, full coat. Yeah, we need reeds and feathers for survival coats. Just gonna sit it on leather for now, and we can upgrade this one too. And I have a feeling I have let this episode run for very, very long. So I think I better stop it right here, and then I may see you guys in the next episode. Let me know if you want to see more of this. I think I was a little distracted in this episode, but well, I'm gonna be playing it anyway, so if you want to see how it's gonna go, then let me know. So take care everyone, and see you guys.